Emails I Can't Send. That title makes me so excited. Yeah. I don't know what it is about that title, but I love albums that sound and feel like a diary just because I feel like it can go anywhere.
It's funny, actually, based on the title and that you like it so much, that I saw a video on her Instagram that she was sending herself emails almost acting as if her therapist when she didn't have one. Mm. So I thought that was an interesting, dare I say, concept or like theme.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And that's very therapeutic.
And then it, you know, kind of started or catapulted the songwriting journey to then create Emails I Can't Send.
That's a perfect way to pick topics too. Documenting what goes on in your life as it happens and then creating these songs around it. I mean, yes, that's what songwriting is. But having a whole album that stems from that, I think is a beautiful thing, so.
Now, we do know there was a song called Because I Like the Boy that dropped.
Now,
when the album dropped with the music video. One, that music video looks amazing.
It
I'm
does.
Just gonna point that out.
Yes.
But two, we have not heard it, but that song is making some noise.
Something's
so that one I'm actually really interested to hear.
Yeah, that's why I feel like it could go anywhere. Like, Emails I Can't Send. Like, how many emails are there?
You know? right.
Sabrina says this is the first album where she is herself. Not only does the title and cover make me excited, but you guys have not made me excited. The way that you guys have been promoting this album, telling us we need to react to it, I have very high expectations.
I ain't gonna lie, yes. I do. Before we get started, we just wanted to let you guys know that our Patreon is up and running. And over there, you can actually find our exclusive reactions to the two singles' music videos, okay?
I thought you were gonna name them so.
Well, yeah, that's Fast Times and Skinny Dipping. So go ahead and head over there. I don't know, maybe you'll find Because I Like the Boy.
It's times like these, wish I had a time machine so I could see what you did October 13th at 10:15. Were you lying to me and the family? You disgust me, don't make me cuss you out. Why'd you let me down? Don't say sorry now. I can't love right, I get nice guys and villainize them. If I do, then I blame you for every worst that I assume. One fucks our lives and one selfish. I don't think I'll find forgiveness as fast as mom did. And God, I love you, but you're such a dipshit. Please fucking fix this, cause you are all I looked up. I can't even look at you.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
I mean, as they say in Chicago, we had it coming.
Oh, man.
I did not expect to pick up from that place.
Me either.
I didn't know. This is new information to me.
Oh, man. That's about her dad.
Yeah.
And him cheating. That's crazy.
I'm not gonna lie. I was expecting, like, love.
I thought it was gonna be love. I kid you not. Until I was looking, I was like, that's weird. Lied to me and the family. I said, okay. Could have been a close boyfriend.
That is
Don't think I'll find forgiveness as fast as I did. Jordan, because you were all I looked up to, now I can't even look at you. That is such a deep line. That's crazy.
This was...
How beautifully written. I'm gonna let you talk.
I was really gonna say the same thing. This was beautifully written and beautifully approached. Like, I loved the progression in the song. You could feel, I don't wanna say... anger, maybe it was intensifying as it was going along, as more details were unraveling.
Yes.
Like, that felt like, what a way to kick it off. I'm, like, shocked right now.
And I love that the fact that it's called Emails I Can't Send, because I feel like it's something that she just bottled up.
Yes.
And it's like, okay, I can't necessarily tell this to you.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, this is almost, in hindsight, the email I can't send.
Yes.
Oh my god, that's
That is
good.
So, like,
that's
whoa.
Good. That's
Lyrically,
good.
I loved this. It's picking up from a place that's kind of foreshadowing what we're going to talk about.
Right.
Or where these feelings are going to come from.
Right.
She's talking about how it's become hard to trust. So I feel
how
like...
How is that going
to
play
how,
into...
Exactly. How is that going to play... in her love life, maybe, or her personal life, or just who she is as a person. Like, how is
this, it kind of feels like this is the genesis. This is what kind of catapulted her into how she handles situations now and how she looks at people and looks at love. Someone I looked up to let me down and it changed the way I love and receive love. This is the perfect way to start it. Wow. I'm in love with that. I love that so much.
1 year, 10,000 bad moments, but it was dressed up in heated emotion. You're lucky I'm a private person. I've quietly carried your burden.
Emails I can't send.
Everyone thinks you're an angel. Oh, you're so vicious. Love me, then pretend you didn't. Why you gotta be so vicious? You like a certain type of woman who's smart but neglects intuition. You just run to whoever is winning.
Wow.
Said that it was me and you for life. Now you're kinda acting like a date. Oh, you're so.
Turn it up. This one's for me.
Yeah.
This one's mine.
White people and their drama.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I like it.
The white woman has done it again.
Crush my heart and wreck my image. Why you gotta be so? Half of me just can't resist it. Why you gotta be so vicious?
Wow.
That was a great.
Wow. That was a good follow. Sorry. Like, it's almost like when the song hits you after it's done.
That was a great second track.
What are you, 10,000 bad moments?
This kind of, the first verse struck me as a continuation of the first track.
Yes.
But playing out in somebody else. Kind of carrying, like, that situation kind of changed how she loves and receives love.
Yes.
She's kind of narrating now this relationship where she was shown basically exactly what she was afraid of.
No, and I was it's so funny that you mentioned that, because I felt like this song plays into, you know, it's almost like something traumatic happens in your life. So let's say that was the cheating, right? Mm-hmm. And so it does, you know, subconsciously, or, you know, you could be aware, change the way that you perceive love. Mm-hmm. So then when you are put in a relationship and that person shares the same characteristics of the person you've seen done someone else close to you wrong, it just feeds that reason as to, like, this is why I don't trust.
Exactly.
This is why I don't love.
It reaffirms
this. This is why, it reaffirms it.
I think sonically this one was great.
Yeah,
I love the calmness. But it progressed too.
Yes. And then, oh, you're so vicious.
Right. Even the chorus progressed.
It just progressed a little bit.
But then that last one, she started screaming. Another detail I liked in the chorus was how sharp the word vicious came in.
You're so vicious.
It's like, it just adds to that, you know,
that kind of.
It adds to the title of the song.
Yeah, because the word is so, it carries such a punch.
It does.
You know what I mean?
So. But it's kind of quiet and seductive and, like, sneaky.
Yeah, sneaky, that's a good word.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, she woke up and chose violence.
No.
Yeah.
This is the little girl that was on Girl Meets World?
Yeah.
She's not so little no more.
Yo, I'm not. sorry. Because I'm not about to play with it. I'm glad I got that warranty because I'm about to punch.
You're not about to give me sexy, sultry. I don't know if you realize, but when Jordan and I get excited, we
get violent. And
we get violent. We're going to get through this. Jordan, we're only 50 fucking seconds in.
Yeah, but it's your fault, Sabrina.
You're gonna be hearing that a lot.
Yeah, Sabby.
That's the song.
See, when you're talented, things like this are to be expected.
That was an incredible song. Like production, lyrically, it's about indecisiveness. This person swears that they changed again, following that theme of, you know, maybe inconsistencies. You know what I mean? In a person that you're romantic with, and it's like, damn, motherfucker, I can't read your mind. You say you want these things from me, and your actions do not align with it. So
just the back and forth, and again,
this is once again playing with trust.
The trust factor again.
And I really wonder if that's going to be a big factor on this album.
And not being able to trust people's words, not being able to trust people's actions, not being able to trust their intentions. I love that line where she says she's second guessing texts. Like when you're to that point where you have to like make sure you're reading text the way that they were intended, you know something's going on. So yeah. This song was relatable.
This one I have to give it 10.
She could have ended the album right there.
We were never in the park, talking on a seesaw, teetering with our feelings in the dark, ignoring tornado warnings. Don't understand how quickly we get right back in our rhythm without missing a step. I guess maybe that's why.
It's a therapist herself.
Waste that session.
It's a therapist herself because she says she was sending herself emails acting as her own therapist.
Lying to herself.
Is that it?
Sabrina, I'm going to sue you. Therapist. I'm going to sue you.
Yeah.
Sue me. Let's go.
I deserve an hour in the week to focus on my thoughts, not so obsessed with yours. I can hear myself speak.
This reminds me of skinny dipping.
Some of my feelings in the basement, so I still have some left.
The basement is down, right?
Yeah.
Buried down. I think of how we bury things.
Yeah.
So I like that choice of words. Kept my feelings in the basement. I liked that.
Yeah.
That was another great song.
And I actually love how the title was strategically placed in there. Because again, when you get that tornado warning on your phone, it's almost like that red flag. That tornado warning is that red flag and the storm that's about to come with it. Funny, because the song coming after that is Because I Like the Boy, the storm that came with that. Yeah,
that came with that, we're assuming.
I have a feeling that Tornado Warnings and Because I Like the Boy are somehow connected. Just again, that red flag and how it all seems so good in the beginning and then in some form of fashion, just all comes crashing down. I do feel like the therapist is herself.
I love that
and
theory.
And I keep lying to myself.
I think that that's it.
I think that's it. And if that is it, it makes it even better because what a clever way
of tying that in.
Yeah.
This mellow vibe, it's a really nice vibe that makes me feel like I'm constantly outside.
I do feel like
in the wind.
The trees.
Yeah, I feel like I'm one with the trees right now. And it's okay.
I said I wanted sentiment, and you said you knew a guy who knew cuddling on trampolines could be so reckless. We bonded over black-eyed peas and complicated exes. Now I'm a homewrecker, I'm a slut. I got death threats filling up some of my trucks. Tell me who I am, cause I don't have a choice. I'm a rebound, getting around, stealing from the young. Tell me who I am.
Oh, we know who the young is.
I'm about to pack up my shit.
All because I like the boy. Was only trying to hold you close while your heart was failing. It's not an illusion, just to.
Did he go to the hospital?
Oh, it's done. Turn off. I don't want no more. No more.
Yeah. Shit.
Yeah.
Shit. Okay.
She did this in the most low-key way possible.
Yeah.
I'm too late to be your first love, but I'll always be your favorite.
Ooh.
Now I'm a homewrecker, I'm a slut. Tell me who I am, cause I don't have a choice. All because I like.
This is the perfect album to put this on. Emails I can't send. This is shit that you feel like you can't say, but like it's the truth. Yeah. This is what happened. Yeah. This is what happened to me. Wow.
Hell yeah.
Skin was like a little, like a little tease. Wow. I can't tell you who I am because you've already decided.
Yeah.
I don't have a choice here.
It's not.
You're telling me who I am.
It's all because of the company that you just
have. Wow.
Good.
Oh, I see why she put that one out.
That was very well written.
Very well written.
That was, I have to be honest, that was well written. And mind you, we have listened to all three of them.
Tell their story.
Three of them.
Yeah.
Tell their story. You can't say who was right and who was wrong in the situation. It's just so subjective. It truly is. Over here on this channel, because we are fans of all three of them, we never allow for one story to not be told.
Right.
And Sabrina, you told your story and you told it sonically and lyrically well.
Right.
And we just did.
Have to validate everyone's side of the story.
You have to validate everyone's side of the story.
Everyone's got a different perspective.
Yeah.
Everyone played their own different part and everyone went through their own separate things.
No,
so
they did.
I feel like the world is pretty much past this situation.
Yes.
However, I admire the fact that Sabrina wrote a song about it and took her time the same way that, let's just be honest, Joshua did.
And just because the world is over, it doesn't mean the person that went through it is.
And sometimes you have to sit with it so that you can even understand how you feel.
Exactly.
And especially if you're going to communicate it to the world, you know, I just feel like there's so much that goes into it. I feel like it was raw. I feel like it was real. I feel like it was honest. Sonically, I think it complemented the topic too.
It did.
And maybe this just adds to the trust issues.
Yeah.
Because you're right about the connection to Tornado Warning. All because I liked a boy, and all because it was innocent, we ignored the signs around us.
And now look.
And now look. Exactly. The tornado comes, and now I'm a slut, and I'm a homewrecker.
Yeah, exactly. You can't expect, you know, once you move on from something, you know, the general public, you expect the person that went through it to move on when they never got to tell their side without being scrutinized for
it. Exactly.
And honestly, like we said, skin was just kind of this, okay, here's this, you know, I can touch on it a little bit.
It was a light touch.
But because I liked the boy, this is Sabrina speaking her truth. This is what happened.
Wow.
All the shit went on when they were
done. They weren't even together. But that shows you how much the world actually knows.
Exactly.
That's why people would have to stop speaking on things that they have no parts of.
It's ridiculous. Like, I'm about to chastise you and you're not even with this person?
Hey, like, yes, they're public figures. But ultimately, we don't know anything.
Like,
so we only know what they tell. So I think it was a gorgeous song.
Tens for that one.
A beautiful addition to the album. It was an important addition. And I'm glad Sabrina finally got it off her chest.
Yeehaw.
We've been talking for hours, but we shouldn't talk for hours on end.
Oh, I like that.
Kissing after a conversation about how we'd probably be better off as friends. Same time.
Same.
I can't even do that.
That wasn't even it.
You.
Bitch, fuck you.
Yeah, you know, Sabrina, there's a lot of things you're doing on this album that are making me feel away.
Make me fall. You can, yeah. Say I'm done, but I'm still confused. How am I supposed to close the door when I still need closure? How am I supposed to leave you now that you're already over? Selfishly, don't wanna give you time to be on someone else's lips. But I'll take 3 short hours over 3 long weeks, pretending like we don't exist.
Well, this has parallels to other songs.
That was good.
Oh, not one miss.
And you know what's funny? I take that as a double meaning.
Okay.
I take that one as, how am I supposed to leave you? How am I supposed to get over you when what we had was over so abruptly almost? Mm-hmm. That it's like, there's no point in me going back, and there's no point in me quote-unquote leaving you because I didn't have a choice to, or it almost felt like I didn't have a choice to. But then also, physically, how am I supposed to leave you now that you're actually in my face? I don't have the willpower to do that.
It's harder, yeah.
Yeah, I take that both ways.
Yeah, I definitely see how this ties in
to the last two songs.
I would say, yeah. When I read After the Aftermath, I wonder if that has any relation to the last song.
Right.
And whether things could have continued a little bit, or maybe re-sparked, or they spoke again. I don't know. It's almost like that idea of doing something that you know is kind of wrong.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
And there's fun in that.
Yeah, but not even just wrong maybe towards somebody else, but wrong for the wrong two of you. It just doesn't work. I think a cat just came from under my bed. All I know is we're 6 tracks in, and I love this album.
Yeah.
You used to fork once. It turns out forks are fucking everywhere. We sat on the roof once. Conversation took us everywhere. I consider you, I'm not trying to. The corner in the mind is well established. I wonder how many things you think about before you get to me. I feel myself falling further down your priorities. And I still make excuses for you constantly. Remember when you left once? That never made too much sense to me. You really came to me for sympathy. I wonder how many things you think about before you get to me.
I love that pause.
Yeah, right, I wonder how many things you wanna do. You think I'm in between? Am I nice? Even a second thought. Damn. Feel myself falling further down your priorities. And I still make excuses for you constantly.
To be a 4-minute song, that was a very easy listen.
Yeah, definitely touching on what happens when you put somebody before yourself constantly.
Yeah,
and you can love people so much and so hard, and sometimes you can even fall in love with the idea of them or yes. the two of you.
Yes,
to where again you ignore those red flags.
Yes,
and yes. you begin to accept things that you shouldn't, and I yes. think that brings you to a crossroads.
Oh, for sure.
Where you have to either make the decision to stick it out or be brave enough to walk away.
Yeah, I think it's just a moment of you kind of listen to your doubts. You kind yeah. of listen to your inner thoughts. Reflecting on the relationship, how it makes her feel or how it made her feel
mm-hmm.
in the moment.
Yeah.
In the moment. That was a very sweet listen. I love that, yeah. that break. It was very different.
It's pretty.
I like that. Sick up?
You ain't stay down for long. I'm a private person.
Wow, this is good. Wow,
that I like that one a lot.
That was good, and that was definitely the narrative kind of flipped on its
yeah,
head there.
Yeah, definitely.
And it was like, okay, now you're feeling what I feel when I didn't want to, when I wanted to be selfish
yep.
and not have your lips touch anybody else's, now mm-hmm. you don't like that somebody else is holding me.
Exactly, exactly. Instead of saying, like, I'm gonna let you control the narrative, but we know what it is.
We know what really happened.
So that's kind of
like, this is almost a song where it's like, oh, you know what really happened.
I love songs like this. I feel like we hear them a lot, where it's like, don't know what you got till it's gone, pretty much.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's I love seeing her kind of stand up in that way.
Yeah, don't know what you got till it's gone. I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they realize how much she's worth after leaving. And yes. that sucks when that happens.
Oh, but it sucks.
Honestly, don't you got to look at that as...
it's gone. Don't seem to go.
Okay. I don't even know what I was going to say now.
Because don't love seem to go. When you don't know what you got till it's gone.
I don't know what I was going to say now.
I want to pause it, but I won't. Because this shit sounds good. Think I only want one number in my phone. I might change your contact, but don't leave me alone. You said you like my eyes and you like to make them bold. Baby, my time goes numb. Sounds like blah, blah, blah. I love that. Baby, I'm in too deep. I'll be honest. Looking at you got me thinking nonsense. Feels so good. Jump some fucking off.
The back is out.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm talking wow, wow thoughts. You got hey, I like wow, wow thoughts. I got the L-O-V-E. How do you do this to me? Better get on myself. When you get close to me, it's a loss on the road. It's about you and me. I'll be honest. I think I got it next, but I forgot it. And I can't see much of it. That's the last day. That was nice. This song catchier than chicken pox is. Bet your house is where my other sock is. Oh, ooh. Woke up this morning, thought I'd write a pop hit. Quickly, can you take your clothes off, pop quiz?
That one's not gonna make it. Most of these aren't gonna make
it. Oh, they made it.
Oh, they made it.
Let me find out somebody got rap. Let me find out we're getting a rap album.
I do. That too. Reminds me of like an interlude.
A little bit.
I love this shit. Bit, I think it's one of the best albums of 2022.
Yeah, I would say so. Sorry. This is a very consistent album.
Sorry, this is so cohesive, so consistent. She's sexy, the cover's sexy, the songs are sexy, the songwriting's sexy, the beats are sexy, yeah. The tracklist is sexy.
Everything's sexy. It's very personal too, still.
It's so personal. I love it. I love how much... Listen, this shit's on both single acts. Sorry.
Listen, we ain't even get to the second one. We know.
Sorry, I know this shit's on Singular Act 2.
Who was Dum Diddy Dum Dum Dums? I don't know. I know Fast Times.
Okay, let's not get crazy. Because Dums is good.
Okay, but Sumi is better than Dums.
What the f- Jordan, you Julian, are dumb.
I'm not doing this again. Like, literally.
No, you are dumb. But this shit does sound good after nonsense. This shit sounds good after nonsense.
Yeah, because the momentum's up.
Yeah. Sounds up too soon like they're like savings. Mixed emotions are hard. And we're on sex. I love it.
Oh, that's sex. True!
Let's go. I had that muscles and understatement. Sky looks so broken like it tasted. And boy, what the fuck is patience? These are fast times. Yeah. Give me a second to forget I ever really meant it. Fast times, yeah. My feelings used to be so rated. But you speak in such a perfect cadence. Tiptoeing past so many stages, but what the fuck is patience? No time for rewrites, we couldn't help it. Closed eyes and closed eyes, we couldn't help it. These are the fast times. These are the.
I'm talking about this being great.
A hit.
I
mean, like we said, we did react to the song over on our Patreon. So if you want to see our initial reaction, go ahead and join.
I like it. I think it takes a break from the heavy emotion.
Yeah, for sure.
And kind of touches on those moments where you're kind of ignoring everything else you're feeling. And you're just living for those fast moments where you don't have to think so much.
Yeah.
Give me a second to forget I ever really meant it.
This cat is just going crazy. Papa.
Or I think about the lyric, no time for rewrites. We're writing emails I can't send. So it's kind of just like, it's very straight shooter. You know, she's just having a good time at this point. And maybe even experiencing a new person.
A new person, so, yes.
It'll be Wednesday, I'll be going in this coffee shop. Hear the barista call an oat milk latte in your name. And I look up from my phone and think there's no chance it's you, but it is. You'll say hi, I'll say hi, how are you? Say, well, this was really nice, maybe we should do this on purpose sometime. And it'll be long enough that we won't harp on arguments in your garage. All the ways we sabotaged it.
I love that so much.
You suggest a restaurant we used to go to, and I'll say, won't that be too nostalgic?
words, and we won't bring up the past. We'll keep it bureaucratic, and we won't say it, but both of us will be thinking about how different we are from those scared little kids that have all those arguments in your garage. Swimming on the edge of a cliff, it'd be so nice, right? If we could take it all off and just exist.
I love that.
I'm resisting, but going down with the ship, it'd be so nice, right? Water under the bridge.
That one hit different today.
Yeah, because, you know, like we said, we also reacted to this over on our Patreon. And when we first listened to it, I couldn't quite put my finger on whether, like, I loved it or if I didn't. I knew that it was very different, but hearing it with the album,
yeah,
it makes so much sense. Definitely talking about reflection, and if it is about that person, then
yeah,
maybe trying to be friends. So that's interesting that the next song's called Bad for Business.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what that means.
I don't know what that could even possibly be referring to, but...
The reason it hits different, though, is because I went through this recently. It's that moment where you reconnect with someone that you spent a lot of time with, and a lot of memories come up. Sometimes it's a lot of bad. But you have this hope that it could be different. You hope that maybe enough time has passed where you've each grown, and maybe you can give it another try.
Yeah.
Ultimately, it didn't work out, but... I remember that feeling of being like, feeling what you felt in the very beginning.
Yes.
And kind of wanting to ignore everything that happened while you were together. And sometimes that works for people, sometimes it doesn't. But that's why I hit differently, because like, I could really see what she was talking about. And then listening to the rest of the album, like, that moment is very real.
He's good for my heart, but he's bad for business. Tears me apart when he grants my wishes. We look good in photographs. I like the way you like to laugh at dirty jokes. I know that I'll always land.
Yeah. But like Carrie Underwood. Like a little, right? Like a little country hit.
If I'm just writing happy songs, will anybody sing along? Can't find a single reason I'd make all the same mistakes again.
I actually really like that one. Actually,
I have another thought. I'm gonna save it.
Okay.
But I will say I like how it comes after Skinny Dipping. Skinny Dipping was kind of like that reconnection. And so Bad for Business is kind of like the excuse and explanation for the reconnection.
Yeah, yeah.
And where you kind of like once again defend this person.
Yes.
Or find reasons for
like,
them to stay.
You're crazy for talking to him again.
Right.
And you're like, exactly. You don't know him like I do.
Right. Right. Yes. I know him.
I know him.
Right.
You know, so that's kind of what this, I feel like that's what Sabrina
said. That's the energy I'm getting.
Song. Yeah. But I love
and
the.
Bad for business. The industry?
Bad for business.
Too controversial?
Ooh.
Now, I don't know if it's all about that.
A double meaning?
It could be a double meaning.
I like that.
Bad for business, bad for my business relationships, bad
for my
reputation. Like, it could be anything like that. So
I like
that. But he's good for my heart.
You're good at the falling, not the staying there. You're good at impersonating someone who cares. And you had me for a minute there.
Ooh, a minute, one song.
I let your confusion keep me up at night.
Oh, I love
I'm so tired, over-analyzing,
I'm back and beside it. Where else can we go? There's nothing left to decode. Don't look emphasizing the gaps in the silence.
Oh, in the silence.
I love that.
There's a weight off my shoulders now that I don't chase you. Being myself, did that emasculate you?
Oh, wow. The album.
I'm so tired, unpacked every single word you wrote, and I, the gaps in the silence, it's just getting old, there's nothing left here to decode.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I love that. Wait, do you think that was an actual insert from a video of the two of them?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's what it sounded like. There's nothing left here to decode at the end of the album.
With emails I can't send, because you can decode.
Yeah.
There's nothing else here to analyze. There's nothing else here to dissect.
Nothing.
What happened, happened.
Right.
It is what it is. Yep. It's done. There's nothing left for me to pull from it.
Wow.
I got my answers. And I said my piece.
That quickly became in my top three, I think.
There's nothing left here to decode.
That jumped up.
Wow, that's amazing.
That was an amazing ender.
Wow.
I love that.
Wow.
Yeah, I love that. I was honestly going to say the album could have ended as Skinny Dipping.
I was feeling that too.
I was actually feeling it at Fast Times. Then I felt it as Skinny Dipping.
No, I felt that Skinny Dipping, but now...
I thought Bad for Business was a good deluxe track. But now I'm like, this is complete.
But this is complete.
The code is amazing.
It's amazing. Emails I can't send and decode. There's nothing left to decode. I got everything I needed to get out. Wow, that's amazing.
I love that song. Let's talk about these emails.
Sabrina, Brina, Breen, Nanas, listen.
Sabby.
This was a great album. This just might be your best.
I think this is your best.
I think it's so well-rounded. I can sense and hear the maturity.
Yeah,
and
it's incredible.
I believe you when you say that this is the first album where you feel like you're you.
Yes.
The music was just, I don't know, it feels like it could be the start of, you know how every artist has that point in their career?
Yes.
Where something shifts. And
yes.
I'm not saying it shifts and the music gets good.
No.
But the music gets better. Like, it just, you can hear this evolution that happens.
Yes, this is gonna be very odd because I feel like Sabrina has disassociated herself with Disney.
Oh,
however,
100%.
This, I don't wanna say almost like solidifies it, but this puts her in the running, even though she should have been from the beginning,
yeah,
with the main quote unquote pop girls.
Yeah.
Because she gave
yeah,
what a pop album is supposed to give.
She
does
told
that
you,
make
I'm
sense?
A pop hit.
This album is beyond cohesive. What I have to give credit to is the songwriting.
Yes.
Lyrically, the stories that this album tells, the sequencing is mm-hmm. perfect. Tornado Warnings, Because I Like the Boy, Already Over, How Many Things, Bet You Wanna. Yeah. That sequencing.
Yeah, that run right there. It's crazy.
Listen, if there's one thing Jordan and I get excited for when it comes to albums, it is sequencing.
Yeah.
Sabrina's music has been mature, but this just brings it to another level.
Yeah.
And I'm actually quite speechless because we didn't know what to expect when coming into this album.
I was gonna say that all of them actually, to your point about it being cohesive, while it is a cohesive album, every song is like its own character.
Yes.
And while they complement each other, they do still stand alone. So I admire the consistency. Obviously with the start of the album, we picked up from a very different place. The Root, we picked up from, you know, the Genesis, like we said. Yeah, we picked up from the Genesis, and it did still end up being an album predominantly about love and relationships.
But it was good to know where it stemmed from.
Yeah.
Most albums don't touch on that, they just kind of touch on it every now and then, but to actually dedicate a song to the Root.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah, if that's the Root.
And having it be the title track.
We're hearing it and reading it as the Root, not only the title track, but, well, yeah, title track and title of the album, because
It's like going through that and accepting that, like we said, sets you up for the rest.
What are your top three?
I know you're gonna ask that. Yeah. I have to definitely go with Read Your Mind. This is out of order. Read Your Mind, Decode, and maybe Emails I Can't Send, or Tornado Warning, or Because I Like the Boy. I don't know. Don't ask me hard questions.
I know my favorite off the album is Read Your Mind, but I'm stuck between Because I Like the Boy, Vicious, Bet You Wanna, and Decode.
Really?
Yeah.
Because I really loved Already Over as well.
But I loved Bad for Business.
I don't know.
I feel like that's going to be criminally underrated.
Give me a vinyl. I'm only seeing CDs. What's going on?
Yeah.
Pre-order's coming?
Yeah. I think it's one of the best of 2022. I'm going to be very honest with you. I think it's an incredible album.
I mean, there are quite a few takeaways. And Sabrina, I just want to say congratulations.
Yeah.
Proud of you. I want to shout out everybody that was involved with this album. All of the writers. I'm not sure if Sabrina was the only one writing.
I saw, when looking at the credits, I saw Julia Michaels.
Yeah, Julia Michaels. A lot.
Who's an incredible songwriter.
Right. So I want to shout out everybody that was involved.
Yeah.
And once again, this album cover, I just...
Yes. Yeah. The back is out.
The back is out.
As always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about the album. Let us know your top three down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching this react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications. That way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one.